This is your listen and respond for this week. Miss Malarkey Leaves No Reader Behind by Jenny Finchler and Kevin O'Malley. So here is the front cover of this story. Oops. And here is the back. So you can also look on the copy that I made you. So go ahead and take a minute now and make sure you have your name on here and the date. And then the title is going to go here, Miss Malarkey Leaves No Reader Behind. Go ahead and write down, do your preview. Readers always collect clues before they get started reading. Look at the front and back covers of the book before you start reading, listening to the story, and fill in this chart below. What do you think this book is going to be about? Number one, I think this book will be about blank. Why do you think this? I think this because blank. Number two, another thing this book might be about is blank. I think this because blank. So go ahead and fill in both of these and both of these. Why you think each thing. And once you've done that, then you can jump back into the story. And remember, the next thing we're going to be wondering about are the characters. So let's see. It's the first week of school, and this year, Miss Malarkey said our class would be doing the Everybody Reads in America program. She thinks that reading is about the finest thing a person can do, and she promises to find each of us a book we'll love before the end of the year. Our school is supposed to read 1,000 books by June 12th. Principal Wiggins says that if we can read that many books, he will dye his hair purple and sleep on the roof of the school. I'd love to see that, but there's one problem. I hate reading. In October, Miss Malarkey gave me a book of scary stories. I don't like scary stories. I like video games, and so do my friends. Edwin is from Senegal. He doesn't speak English very well yet, but he really likes math. Sam is good at lacrosse. Jamal likes to draw. Me, I like aliens, race cars, funny jokes, chewing gum, hot sauce, and doing cannonballs at the pool. Miss Malarkey handed out a list of books that somebody said we should try. The school year is going by fast. It's already December. Everybody is reading, everybody but me and my friends. We walked by Susie Kurtzmeren. Her backpack was so crammed with books, she looked like she was going to fall flat on her back. What's in the backpack, I asked. Rocks? We saw Larry Stork reading a book on his way home. He walked right into a telephone pole. Ellen Japson ran by really fast. Where's the fire? Yelled Sam. In the book I'm reading. It's great, yelled Ellen. The world is going crazy, said Jamal. We went to my house and played video games. So let's go ahead and fill in some of our characters. So I don't think we know the narrator's name, so I'm just going to write narrator. If we find it out later, maybe we can fill it in. So he likes aliens. He likes video games. Does not like books. And then there's the teacher, Miss Malarkey, trying to get everybody to read. And then you can fill in this third one with some things about that person, maybe some of his friends, maybe the principal, I don't know. Pick somebody and write it down. What is the setting of the story? You're going to write that down. And then how does it match with what's happening? So they're talking about being at school and working with their principal and their teacher. So think about how that would make sense if they were like stranded on a desert island or in the North Pole. Would that make as much sense as if they were at school? That's why we're thinking about the setting and what's happening to make sure it makes sense with what's happening in our story. Okay, let's see what happens next. Every time we finish a book, Miss Malarkey puts a blue ribbon on the wall with our name and the book title. She sure has put up a lot of ribbons. Susie Kurtzmeren has 25 ribbons on the wall. Charles Dewey has 15. And Brenda Johns finished 5 books this week. I mean, 5 books in 1 week? How can she do that? Doesn't she eat? Miss Malarkey keeps giving me books. She says she'll find a book for me if it kills her. I don't want her to die, so I told her I'd keep trying. When I tried to read one of them after I played video games, I fell asleep. It's February now, and Miss Malarkey is still trying to find a book I'll love. She gave me a fantasy book, but the names were confusing. In March, Miss Malarkey gave me a book of jokes, but I'd heard them all before. In April, she tried a book of poems. I don't know what she was thinking. Miss Malarkey doesn't give up easily. In May, she gave me a book about crazy mixed-up explorer guys, but I lost interest before they even set sail. It's June now, and some of my friends came over to play video games. Everyone but Sam. Miss Malarkey gave him a book Friday, said Adwin. Maybe he reading? No way, I said. He's out playing some sport. We called Sam's house. His mother said, he's busy right now. I'll have him call you when he's done. He's reading. So I want you to stop here. Let's go ahead and make a prediction. Readers always guess what might happen next. What do you think might happen next? Something I think might happen next is blank. Why do you think this? I think this because blank. Another thing I think might happen next is blank. I think this because blank. Go ahead and write down what you think is going to happen next. So I'm noticing that one of the narrator, the person telling the story, one of his friends has stopped coming over to play video games because he is too busy reading a book. What do you think is the next thing that's going to happen? Once you finish that, then you're ready for visualize, and I will let you know when we're going to pause for that one so you can come back and finish the story after you finish that section. It's been months since we started the OG Wiz Aren't Books Great program. Miss Malarkey keeps giving me books to read, but I just don't get it. Our class has read 275 books. Our school has read 869 books. Adwin, James, and I have read zero. Excuse me. Video games are just so much cooler. One day at lunch, I sat down with Sam, Adwin, and Jamal. Adwin kept looking down at his lap. Did you wet your pants or something? I laughed. Not wet, said Adwin, and he lifted up a book he was hiding under the table. Miss Malarkey gave me this book, good book about math guy. His name, David Blackwell. That's great, Adwin, I said. You enjoy your stupid book, but Jamal and I are going to be video game masters. Actually, said Jamal, I thought that was a good book when I read it too. And I don't think I even like math. I like when the guy said, I like pictures, formulas, and symbols. I don't especially like them. He was a pretty cool guy. My jaw hung open. How long have you been reading books, Jamal? A while now, I guess. I didn't want to make you feel bad. See, Miss Malarkey gave me this book about a painter named Van Gogh. You know how I like cool pictures. This book had a lot of them. My friends read now. They still play video games, but not quite as much. Sometimes when they come over, they bring books and trade them. Sometimes they barely even play the video games. They talk about books. On June 10th, our school had a big assembly for the reading program. We're getting close to the goal of reading 1,000 books. The teachers bought a special sleeping bag for Principal Wiggins for when he sleeps on the roof of the school. The school has read 999 books. Our class has read 334. And how many books have I read? Zero. The next day, Miss Malarkey asked me to stay after school. I thought maybe she was going to yell at me about all the books I didn't finish. I tried to like reading books. I really did. I tried sports books, science books, joke books, fantasy explorer, and detective books. What was I supposed to do? When I got to Miss Malarkey's room, she had this crazy smile on her face. She said, "This year I found out a lot about you. I found out you don't like girl stories, dead baseball players, and math tricks. I found out you're not mean, you don't lie, and you love video games. You like cool sneakers, your lucky number is 15, and your favorite uncle is in the army. Your mother's name is Carol, and your father's name is Bob. This year, I found out even more about you. You, my boy, like aliens, race cars, funny jokes, chewing gum, hot sauce, and doing cannonballs at the pool." Then she yelled, "Have I got a book for you?" I went home that day and started to read. It was the greatest book ever made. It had aliens and race cars and funny jokes and chewing gum and hot sauce and cannonballs. It even had a pool. I read right through dinner, and at 10 o'clock, my mom and dad came up to see if I was feeling all right. The next day, Mom wrote a note to Miss Malarkey and told me to give it to her. "Okay, son, turn out the light." "Hold on, I'm almost finished." So I want to pause right here. I want you to fill in this visualize. Readers always think about how this story might look in their heads. What do you think this part of the story might look like? So what do you think that book that Miss Malarkey gave him had in it? I want you to talk about that for these two questions and tell me why you think that. Why you think the book would have that, whatever you think will be in it. Why do you think it will be in it? Okay, so you're going to fill in both sections, both numbers, and both reasons. Once you finish that, you can finish the story. Turns out I hadn't read the 1000th book. I read number 1001. That's okay, because I got to read the greatest book ever. Miss Malarkey gave me a hug and said, "Congratulations!" When school was over, everyone went outside and looked up at the roof. We all yelled, "Good night, Principal Wiggins! Good night, students, and good job!" So now you're going to finish this last part. Summarize. Readers think about the most important parts of a book. In your own words, give me a summary of the story you just listened to. So the story blank, so title of the story. So Miss Malarkey, so this may not fit, just put Miss Malarkey. Talks about a boy who doesn't like reading. In the beginning of the story, what happens in the beginning? In the middle, what's happening in the middle? What happens at the end? Has anybody changed their opinion of things? Once you finish that, you're going to flip to the back. Please remember that you're going to do this on Google Classroom. Please do not ask me if you have to do this. Yes, you have to do this. It's on the back paper. It's there for you to do. You do not have to do both of them. You need to pick one or the other. So you're going to be posting this in your Google Classroom. You're going to start a new post. If you pick Making Connections, you're going to talk about how this book is similar to your own life. You're going to title the book, the post, Making Connections to Miss Malarkey. So you're not going to write on this paper. You're going to type this on Google Classroom. I'm just showing you what the title will be. Then you're going to talk about how you can connect to this book. Did this remind you of something that's happened to you or something that happened to maybe one of your friends? Or maybe you saw this on TV or in another book. Go ahead and give me one or two sentences about how this connects to something that you've experienced. After that, you can look for an image and put that image into the post if you would like to. If you don't want to do that one, you're going to be working on story continued. Readers think about what might happen next if this book were to keep going. So you're going to title the post, Miss Malarkey, continued. Okay, so that's what you're going to type, Miss Malarkey continued. So write about what might happen next if the story were to keep going. Do you think he keeps reading other books? Do you think he's done with books? What do you think happened to the principal? What do you think would happen next if the story did not end on that last page and it just kept on going? You can also look for a picture if you would like to add into this and then click post. Once you finish with this, you can finish up any missing assignments or move to Lexia, IXL, or Mobi Max.